Hi, last class I have discussed about three-phase half-controlled converter. There, we have seen that every thyristor conducts for 120 degree and three pulses we have got in one complete cycle. Today, I will discuss about three-phase six-pulse converter. These three-phase converters are very much popular in high-power industrial applications. To understand the triggering process of thyristors, this circuit last class I have explained. From here we have concluded that though three positive voltages are connected across three diodes, but the diode having maximum voltage will conduct and remaining two will remain off. In three phase full wave converter there will be six thyristors. Based on that one more circuit let's discuss. Three negative voltage sources are connected across cathodes of three diodes. Minus 10 volt across diode number 1, minus 8 volt diode number 2, minus 6 volt diode number 3. From here we can say that only diode number 1 will conduct. When diode 1 conduct, then potential of cathodes becomes minus 10 volt, then voltage across diode number 2 is minus 10 minus of minus 8, that means minus 2 volt, and across diode number 3 it is minus 4 volt. We can see the waveform. The voltage across the load resistance is minus 10 volt. It indicates that diode number 1 is on. Voltage across diode number 2 is minus 2 volt and voltage across diode number 3 is minus 4 volt. This indicates that diode number 2 and 3 are off. So it is concluded that though cathode voltages are negative, but the diode having maximum negative voltage will conduct. Based on this one, we will see in three phase full wave converter the thyristors having maximum negative voltage will conduct. Across three thyristors, if three negative voltages are there, then out of those three thyristors only one thyristor will conduct, which have maximum negative voltage. Let's see. The circuit diagram shows three phase full wave converter. Three phase source VR, VY, VB is connected across three legs of this three phase converter. In leg 1, two thyristors are there, T1 and T4, leg 2, T3 and T6, leg 3, thyristor T5 and T2. We can say that top three thyristors will trigger if voltage across the thyristor is maximum out of these three phase voltages, and the bottom three thyristors T4, T6 and T2 will conduct if voltage across the thyristor is, or cathode voltage of the thyristor is negative maximum. At a time two thyristors will conduct to give positive output voltage across the load resistance. Let's see the waveform. VR, VY, VB are three phase voltages. VY lacks the supply voltage VR by 120 degree. VB lacks the supply voltage VR by 240 degree. We can see from 30 to 150 degree, VR is maximum. From 150 to 270, VY is maximum. And 270 to 390 or 30 degree, VB is more than VR and VY. Likewise, we can see negative voltages. Between 30 to 90, VY is negative maximum. From 90 to 210, VB is negative maximum. Then 210 to 330, VR is negative maximum. As we have discussed that out of T1, T3 and T5, the thyristor will be on which has maximum positive voltage. And out of T4, T6 and T2, the thyristor will be on which has maximum negative voltage. So let's see. from 30 to 90, VR is more than other two voltages, VY and VB. So from top three thyristors, T1 will be on during 30 to 150 degree. Now between 30 to 90 degree and 90 to 150 degree, we have to select the negative maximum value. So 30 to 90 negative maximum is for VY. So corresponding thyristor will be on, that is T6. And from 90 to 210, VB is negative maximum. So the corresponding thyristor T2 will be on. So we can observe from here that from 30 to 90, thyristor number 6 and 1 is on, and from 90 to 150, thyristor number 1 and 2 is on. Likewise, from 150 to 210 degree, thyristor number 2 and 3 is on. 210 to 270, thyristor number 3 and 4 is on. Then from 270 to 330, 4 and 5 is on. Then from 330 to 390, thyristor number 5 and 6 is on. Then from 30, again the cycle will start and thyristor number 6 and 1 will be on. So we can see there are 6 output pulses because of this 6 pair of thyristors, and the switching sequence are 6-1, 1-2, 2-3, 3-4, 4-5, 5-6. That's why this kind of converter are also known as 3-phase 6 pulse converter, as 6 pulses of output voltage we are getting in complete 360 degree. We can see from here that every thyristor conduct for 120 degree and a pair operates for 60 degree. Then after 60 degree, a new thyristor is turned on and the earlier one is commutated. This is because of the reverse voltage appearing across thyristor number 6. So after thyristor number 6 and 1, thyristor number 1 and 2 will continue to conduct. You can see that after 90 degree, VY is more than VB. So the favorable condition is there for thyristor number 2. So 6 will be off and 2 will be on. So likewise, these pulses will continue and 6 pulse output voltage we will get from the resistance R. Let's connect a RL load across the same system. Here the firing angle is shifted by angle alpha. So the conduction period of the thyristor pairs are also shifted by alpha. So the thyristor 6 and 1 will continue from 30 plus alpha to 90 plus alpha. Likewise, the cycle will continue and 6 output voltage pulses we will get across the resistance R. The difference between 3-phase half-wave converter and full-wave converter is that here 6 pulses of output voltage we are getting across the load. Because of this, the ripple across the output voltage is reduced. But in 3-phase half-wave converter, 3 pulses of output voltage we have got and ripple across the output voltage is comparatively more. So the frequency of this ripple is 6 times the fundamental frequency. And in case of 3-phase half-wave converter, we have seen 3 times the fundamental frequency. Now, from 30 plus alpha to 90 plus alpha, when thyristor number 6 and 1 is on, we can say that the output voltage is difference between the two supply voltages, and the supply voltage is because of VR and VY. So the output voltage is VRY. So when thyristor number 6 and 1 is on, output voltage is VRY. And when thyristor number 1 and 2 is on, between 90 plus alpha to 150 plus alpha, you will get the output voltage VRB, that is VR minus VB. Then 2-3 VYB, 3-4 VYR, 4-5 VBR, 5-6 VBY, and again 6-1 BRY. So like this, the cycle will continue, and 6 pulses of output voltage at 6 times the fundamental frequency we will get across the output voltage. Let's find the average and RMS output voltage of this 3-phase full wave converter. Let the supply voltage VR is Vm sin theta, Vy Vm sin theta minus 120, Vb Vm sin theta plus 120. So the line voltage VRY is equal to root 3 Vm sin of theta plus pi by 6. Then here we will find the output voltage of a single pulse across load resistance when thyristor number 6 and 1 is on. Then we will multiply it by 6 to find the average and RMS output voltage. So V0 is equal to 6 multiplied by 1 by 2 pi, and range of conduction period is from pi by 6 plus alpha to pi by 2 plus alpha, and the output voltage is VRY d theta, and you will get 3 root 3 by pi Vm cos alpha. Now the RMS output voltage you will get V0R is equal to 6 times 1 by 2 pi, pi by 6 plus alpha to pi by 2 plus alpha VRY square d theta, and ultimately you will get root 3 Vm square root of 1 by 2 plus 3 root 3 by 4 pi cos of 2 alpha. So from these two expressions, it is clear that if the firing angle is changed, then RMS and average output voltage will vary. If firing angle is more than 90 degree, then average output voltage is negative and it will operate in inversion mode. And if the firing angle is less than 90 degree, then it will operate in rectification mode. So by changing the firing angle, we can change our mode of operation from inversion to rectification. Based on this one, 3-phase full wave converter can be used for 3-phase dual converter. There, just like single phase dual converter, 2 3-phase full converters are connected back to back in such a way to obtain 4 quadrant operations, and one converter will operate as rectifier, then other converter will operate as inverter. So as I have discussed single phase dual converter in detail, here I am not going to discuss this 3-phase dual converter. So today I have discussed 3-phase full wave converter with R load, RL load, and we have seen that there are 6 pulses of output voltage across the load resistance compared to 3 pulses in 3-phase half wave converter. So 3-phase full wave converter output voltage ripple is comparatively lesser than 3-phase half wave converter output voltage. So 3-phase full wave converter is preferred over 3-phase half wave converter for high power applications. Then we have seen that every thyristor conducts for 120 degree. So after every 60 degree, a new thyristor comes into conduction. At a time, 2 thyristors are conducted. Then we have found out the RMS and average value of the output voltage. These 3-phase full wave converters are also known as 3-phase bridge converter, because the 3-phase supply voltage works as a bridge between the 3 legs of the converters and allowing current to flow through the converter. That's why the naming is 3-phase full wave bridge converter. Thank you.